Let's take a look at two sample portfolios. The portfolio on the left is made up of 50 different U.S. stocks. The portfolio on the right holds one Canadian equity index fund, a U.S. index fund, a developed markets index fund, and an actively managed emerging markets mutual fund. The portfolio on the left has some diversification, but the portfolio on the right is actually much more diversified. Each index fund itself may hold hundreds of stocks, and there is exposure to dozens of countries, not just the US. Diversification is a risk management strategy you can use to lower the overall risk of your portfolio, no matter how conservative or aggressive an investor you want to be. Let's look at the various ways to diversify. Within any market, there are two aspects of risk to consider: systematic risk and non-systematic risk. Systematic risk is the fluctuations of the whole market. This is normally due to economic cycles. Every market, whether it be the Canadian stock market or the US bond market, has its own systematic risk. Non-systematic risk is the risk of an individual company. Whether an economy is strong or going through a bad recession, individual companies' performance can differ from the pack. For example, a company that has made some bad decisions over time could still go bankrupt in a strong bull market. It's generally accepted that holding roughly 20 to 30 different securities will minimize non-systematic risk. You could do that by buying 20 to 30 or more individual stocks or bonds, or you could use investment funds like ETFs or mutual funds, which in turn can hold hundreds and sometimes thousands of different individual securities. But there are other ways to diversify as well. Let's say you had 30 different US stocks. What if they were all technology stocks? That's not as diversified as holding 30 different stocks spread across different sectors of an economy, like materials, energy, financials, consumer staples, healthcare, and so on. You can also diversify by investing in different geographical regions. Because different countries tend to have their own economic cycles, by spreading your portfolio around the world, you may reduce risk in your portfolio by having investments that move in different economic cycles from one another. Finally, another major way to diversify is through asset classes. Not everyone wants or needs a 100% equity portfolio. Many investors might prefer less risk in their investments, and so they add in other asset classes like fixed income. You could also diversify into other asset classes like real estate, infrastructure, private equity, commodities, and others. The goal is to get access to groups of investments that generally move in different patterns. While it can be exciting or nerve-wracking to hold just a few stocks in a portfolio, that's a very poorly diversified portfolio. Using various techniques of diversification can greatly reduce the risk in your portfolio.